The following program is brought to you by Greater Exodus Baptist Church. Now here is today's message.
Folks talking about that I've been a Baptist all my life. I was a Baptist when I was born. I was a Baptist when I was living. I'm going to be a Baptist when I die, and on and on and on and on. You better have a relationship, because your baptism ain't nothing but a religion. Are you hearing what I'm saying? And folks talking about Kojic, got to be Kojic, and everything else is second. Well, let me tell you something. Ain't nobody went to heaven because of Kojic or Baptist. Are you hearing what I'm saying? If you're going to go to heaven, it ain't going to have nothing to do with the church that you are a member of. And if you really want to know the truth, he took care of your salvation before there was a church. Are y'all here? Wasn't no Greater Exodus Baptist Church and no Kojic Church at Calvary?
Yes, sir.
Are y'all, wasn't no Mount Moriah at Calvary? Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? Your salvation took place at Calvary. It's not the church. It's the relationship with God. Hallelujah in this house. Hallelujah in this house. I'm almost finishing here. But the disciples were blind by their judgment. The Pharisees were blind by their religion. The neighbors were blind by their skepticism. Did you read that? They didn't even know whether the man was the man or not. They wanted to deny the miracle so bad. They say, is it him? And then somebody said, it looked like him. But they've been raised with the man. They didn't know that's the man. But they were skeptical. They could not believe that God could do a supernatural thing. And my friend, that is the problem with some of us. We are blind by our skepticism. And we see somebody give a testimony, and we got another name for a good testimony. We call it a test-a-lie. Well, that wasn't no truth. That she was just lying. Well, it could be that God is blessing. Are you hearing what I'm saying? We don't believe the supernatural anymore. We don't believe. Let me tell you something. If you want something supernatural to happen in your life, you've got to trust in a supernatural God. Am I right about it, somebody? Am I right about it, somebody? And you got to have faith in that God, because without faith, it is impossible to please him. Without faith. Not without voice, but without faith. Not without preaching prowess, but without faith. Not with being a great singer, but without faith. Not with being a great instrumentalist, but about faith. You've got to have faith. The just shall live by faith. If you want God to bless you, you got to believe something. You got to believe that the gospel will change somebody's life. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Well, he changed my life. Are you hearing what I'm saying? If he changed me, he can change anybody. You got to believe that God can change somebody's life. When somebody give you a testimony and they tell you how far they have come, you got to believe that God can do that. You got to believe that God can hit a straight lick with a crooked stick. You got to believe that God is able to do exceedingly and abundantly. He can change anybody. Am I right about it? You got to believe something. You got to believe that he's greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. You got to believe that you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. You got to believe that in the time of trouble, he will hide you. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide you. You got to believe that they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. If you want something to happen, you got to believe in the supernatural word of God. You cannot just sit on the premises. You cannot just sit on the premises. You've got to live and stand on the promises of God. Let me ask you a question. Do you believe that God can heal you? Do you believe that God can make a way out of no way? Do you believe that God can cut loose your stammering tongue? Do you believe that God will answer your prayer? Because if you don't believe it, you're wasting your own time. I don't even know why people come to church. They don't believe nothing. Are you hearing what I'm saying? You come to church, you ought to believe something. What are you sitting up here for if you don't believe that that person next to you can put their hands on you and you can be blessed? Why are you here? I'm telling you right now, you got to believe the supernatural. Hallelujah in here. Hallelujah in here. There's somebody in here screaming. I don't know who it is, but the supernatural is doing something in here right now. Hallelujah. You can feel the moving of the Holy Ghost in here right now because he's free, you see. He's free right now. Your skepticism and all that stuff is falling off like a wet tile, and right now the Holy Ghost is in here. The reason why I ask you that question is because in the scriptures it says, in the book of Mark, it says that Jesus could do no mighty works because of their unbelief. And I got to tell you right now, if you don't believe God in here, ain't nothing can happen. And after that, I'm going to ask you one more time. Do you believe God? Do you believe he's able? Do you believe he can bless you? Do you believe he can lift you? Do you believe he can make a way? Do you believe he's a bridge over troubled water? Well, you need to act like you believe it. Somebody stand up on your feet right now and say, I believe God. I believe God. I believe God. I believe God. Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now when the organ go like that, it means I'm supposed to get really going now, right? But sit down, I got another point. See, when that organ, see, in the Baptist church, when that organ goes like that, it's time to wrap it up. You got everybody on your feet. You got to know when you got to exit. You got to take it. That's what they teach in the Baptist church. Amen. Well, somebody tell me, break the rule, Pastor. Break the rule. You can't get blessed until you're willing to break the rules. Yeah, yeah. Am I right about it? The rules of religion. You can't be blessed, Brother Bettison, until you break the rules. Am I right about it? Y'all do remember that fella that was paralyzed, and they got on top of the roof? Huh? And what did they do? They tore a hole in somebody else's roof. Am I right about it? And sometimes when you come to church, you got to tear it up. Are you here? You got to tear up the program. Never mind what the program says. Sometimes you just got to tear it up. Hallelujah in this house. Hallelujah in this house. He tore it up. There's another thing I see here. I see the fear of the disciples because of their judgment. I see the fear of the Pharisees because of their religion. I see the fear of the neighbors because of their skepticism. And finally, I see the fear of the parents. Now, let me ask you a question. If your boy was born blind and somebody came to you and say, what happened? What is going on? Would you say he's of age? Ask him. I wouldn't. If my child was born blind and somebody came to me and I knew that a man called Jesus saved him and cleansed him and opened up his eyes, and you'd have to make me shut up. But these parents are strange birds. They said, we ain't got nothing to say about it. You want to ask him? He's of age. Tell him. He can speak for himself. Because of their fear. Now, what did they fear? I'm going to tell you what they feared. They feared that they would be thrown out of the synagogue. Amen. And you know, the synagogue during that time, there wasn't synagogues on every block like there are churches on every block. Once you're thrown out of your synagogue, you're thrown out of your community. And so they were crippled by their fear of being isolated.
That's right, that's right.
And so they said, oh, no, we better not say anything. You go ask him. Fear is a crippling agent. Am I right about it, somebody? The reason why certain things don't happen in the church is because people are fearful. I was able to scour the congregation when I was asking you to do certain things, and some people didn't want me any harm. They're just afraid. That I've never done it like this before. I've never seen it like this before. I've never felt it like this. And some people are feeling some stuff and holding it back. But the Holy Spirit is trying to uproot your life and make you anew, and you're sitting there fighting it because you're fearful. Listen to me, my friends. There's only one person you need to fear, and that is the Lord. And if you fear the Lord, you ain't got to worry about nobody else. Am I right about it, somebody? Am I right about it? Because one plus the Lord is the majority. I don't care who's against you. Am I right about it? Am I right about it? And so you just need to fear the Lord. As a matter of fact, I have a cure for your fear. And the cure for your fear is the Lord. Are you hearing what I'm saying? I mean, when you come to church on Sunday, you just keep your mind on the Lord. Don't worry about the person sitting next to you. Don't worry about what's at home, but you just get your mind on the Lord. And he said that I will keep you in perfect peace if you keep your mind stayed on me. Do I have a witness in here? Do I have a witness in here? Let me tell you, I got a witness in this text. Yeah. That blind man is a witness. That they said, Mr. Blind Man, how'd you get your sight? And they examined him and they asked him all kinds of questions. And that blind man says, I don't know about all of this theology you're asking me. The blind man said, I don't know about pneumatology. And I don't understand how to speak from your pedagogical approach. And I don't understand the philosophies of the world. And they said, you got to tell us something. And he says, I don't know anything about an ontological God. And I don't know anything about the three O's, omniscient and omnipresent. I don't even know how to pronounce that stuff. But there's one thing. One thing, one thing, one thing, one thing I know. Yeah, the Lord, a man called Jesus. My friend, that's all you need. You don't need anything else. You just need to know the Lord, and everything else will be all right.
Thank you for joining us at Greater Exodus Baptist Church. We hope this message has been a blessing to you. God bless you.